Everyone, I am going to explain question number 1 from exercise 3.2, and this question belongs from 10th class maths. In this question, we have to solve the given quadratic equation by the method of completing the square. So, completing the square method means we have to convert the given equation in the form of a plus b whole square or in the form of a minus b whole square. So I'm just in short I'm writing here that what we have to do, either we have to bring the equation, given equation in the form of a minus b whole square equal to something, or we have to bring the equation as a plus b whole square equal to something. Like this we have to bring. With the left hand side should be in the form of a minus b whole square or in the form of a plus b whole square. So that is named as the method of completing the square. So in that, in this method, so we will proceed like this. There are some particular steps. So step by step you just proceed, automatically your answer will come. The first step is, first is write the question's equation, that is 3x square 5x plus 2 equal to 0. So this equation is given in the question. Then you just keep only the variables in left hand side, constant you just shift in the right hand side. So here the variables terms are 3x square and 5x plus 2 you just shift in the other side. So this is your first step. Keep variable term in one side and constant you just shift in the other side. So then after doing this, we will get the equation as 3x square minus 5x is equal to minus 2. So first step we had done. Now in second step, whatever will be the coefficient of x square, by that you have to divide the complete equation. So in second step, what I said, whatever be the coefficient of x square, so coefficient of x square is 3, so by 3 we will divide this complete equation. So we will get like this. First we will write down that what we are going to do, that is on dividing above equation by 3. So when we will divide the above equation by 3, we will get 3x square upon 3, then minus 5x upon 3 is equal to minus 2 upon 3. Each and every term you have to divide by 3. Here 3 and 3 will cancel. So we will get x square minus 5 upon 3 x is equal to minus 2 upon 3. So I hope it's clear to you what the second step is. In second step, whatever be the coefficient of x square, by that we have to divide. And so each and every terms under this write down 3, and here 3 cancel by 3, and wherever if you can cancel these terms, you should. Just now here 5, I cannot cancel, so I kept the fractions as it is. So we completed the second step also. Now in third step, what we have to do is, whatever be the coefficient of x, that you just write down inside without the sign. You just write down only the coefficient of x without sign in the side somewhere in the rough. So the coefficient of x is 5 upon 3. Multiply it by half. That will give us, if you can cancel here, just cancel them. We cannot cancel anything. So 5 and 5 and 3 2 is 6. So here we get 5 upon 6. So from where I got this 5.3, I took the coefficient of x in the rough column. Without sign you have to take, only take 5.3 and then multiply it by half. Always you have to multiply by half in each and every question. And if you can cancel them, cancel, unless just multiply. So you will get here just now, you cannot cancel, so I have to multiply. So it will give us 5.6. Now what we have to do is, here we have to write down on adding 5 upon 6 square. You have to do the square also in both sides of above equation. So I hope it's clear to you from where I got this. That is, first I kept the coefficient of x inside and I multiplied by half, that gave me 5.6, and then whatever answer will come, you have to do square of that number and you have to add in both the sides of the above equation. So when we do it, we will get this process, that is x square minus 5.3 x plus 5.6 whole square is equal to minus 2 upon 3 plus 5 upon 6 whole square. Now when we solve this, we will get so students, this left hand side we can write as x square minus 2 multiplied by 5.6 multiplied by x plus 5.6 whole square is equal to, and in the right side we just simply solve them. So 5.6 square is 25/36. Now here why I have done this, we just check it out. When we will cancel this 2 and 6, we will get here 2 ones are 2, 2 threes are 6. So what we going to get here? 5/3. So here also 5/3. The meaning is 5/3 I wrote as 2 multiplied by 5/6. Now it is, this left hand side is converted in the form of a square minus 2ab plus b square. So this is, x is our a and 5/6 is our b. So since it is in the form of a square minus 2 into a into b plus b square, so it the formula of a minus b whole square. So we'll write down first here. I'm writing the formula which I'm to use here. That is, since a square minus 2ab plus b square formula is of a minus b whole square. So I'm to use it. So what is our a here? X, and b is 5/6. And since in middle minus sign is there, so it's the formula of a minus b whole square. So the left side is converted into the perfect square. So computing the square method is satisfied. Now here we'll take the LCM. So LCM is 36. Now 36 divided by 3 is 12. So 12 multiplied by minus 2 plus 1 multiplied by 25. Now in next step, x minus 5/6 square as it is, denominator 36 also as it is, 12 2 ja 24, sign is of minus, plus 25 1 ja 25. So what I am doing is, in the left side, since it was in the form of a square minus 2ab plus b square, and this formula's answer is what? A minus b square. So what is a here? X. So x minus b, b is 5/6. So x minus 5/6 whole square. Now this left side will continue as it is, and in the right side you have to take the LCM, and after taking LCM I obtain minus 24 and plus 25 here. So plus minus, what we have to do? Minus and sign of big number. That will give us x minus 5/6 whole square is equal to 1/36. So since 25 and 24, the big number is 25, so it's going to be a plus sign. Now student, we want only x, so square will remove, so we take the square root in the other side. So which implies x minus 5/6 is equal to square root of 1/36. So when student square removes, that time we have to take the square root in the other side. So 1/36 square root is 1/6. Since we are taking the square root, that's why both sign you have to write down, plus as well as minus. Because students, the reason of this is because if we do plus 1/6 square, then also answer is 1/36, and when we do minus 1 upon 6 square, that time also answer is plus 1 upon 36, because minus square is plus. That's why when we take the square root of 1 upon 36, it can be positive 1 upon 6 as well as it can be negative 1 upon 6. So plus minus both sign you have to write down when you are taking the square root of any number. So both are possible. Now we are going to convert it into the first case and second case. Once we will take it as positive 1 upon 6 and the second time we will take it as negative 1 upon 6. So it's going to be case first. In case first, we'll write here when x minus 5 upon 6 is equal to positive 1 upon. So one by one just take the symbol. In case first, just take positive 1 upon 6, and in case second, just take negative 1 upon 6. So 1 upon 6 plus 5 upon 6. Take the LCM here, 6, so 1 plus 5, that will give you 6 upon 6, that is equal to 1. Now, case second, when x minus 5 upon 6 is equal to negative 1 upon 6. That implies to us x is equal to minus 1 upon 6, then again positive 5 upon 6 is equal to, take the LCM, so minus 1 plus 5 is equal to plus 4 upon 6, cancel it, so 2 upon 3. By 2 I cancel here. So what I had done is x minus 5 upon 6, once I took plus sign here. So now we want only x, so minus 5 upon 6 will shift. So when we shift this minus 5 upon 6, it's going to be positive. Now take the LCM, and after LCM all the additions is due, you will get here one answer. In the same way, in case second, instead of plus 1 upon 6, now you have to take minus 1 upon 6. Now similarly we want x, so shift this minus 5 upon 6 in the right side, it will give you plus 5 upon 6. Take LCM, and after taking LCM you will obtain here plus 4 upon 6, because minus 5 plus 5, minus 1 plus 5, plus minus you have to do minus and sign of big number, so we obtain here plus 4. Now by 2 just cancel, 2 2 is 4, 2 3 is 6. So the solution of this equation are 2, that is x equal to 1 and x is equal to 2 upon 3. So we write down here, hence solution of given equation is, so we got the two solutions, so we change it, hence the solutions of given equation are, first one is x is equal to 1 and the second one is x is equal to 2 upon 3. So students, this question is completed. So I hope this question is clear to you. So by we had solved this question step by step. The first step is you have to keep the variables only in the left hand side, and constant you have to shift in the right hand side. And in second step, whatever will be the coefficient of x squared, by that you just divide. And third step, you have to add the square, half of square of coefficient of x in both the sides. So what I said, half of coefficient of x square you have to do, and you have to add in both the sides. That will give you perfect square in the left hand side. And right hand side you simply have to solve by taking LCM and other things. And like this you will get it. So I just request from you all, try the other parts. And in my next video I will upload some tough questions from this question number first of same exercise. And if you have any particular problem, you can write in the comments so that I can clear out your doubts. Thank you.